witness it, but one day. If we were anything, we have to be open to that. And we challenge you to step up to the plate and become part of the solution instead of part of the problem. By going back to the corner and taking up the other prostitute, you are just grabbing that woman or that girl and a chance at having a life. The chance at having something that she feels good about. That's a failure and just a whole thing to stick your penis in.
Sharing that room with my boyfriend, and sometimes if I already had the room, he would have keys, and he would come in the middle of the day. Now, I know how this person used to beat me. How is he going to beat you?
I don't even know where to start. I see it's a lot of old tricks in here. I see a lot of guys with wedding bands on them. The women out there don't like you. They don't care nothing about you. All we see is a dollar sign. How much money do you have? And I would solicit you not to use a condom because you give me $20 or whatever and I tell you, give me 20 more and you don't have to use it. And you would say yes. All you're doing is getting off and then you want somebody to tell you that you got a big one. And so, TV. It's open seats. So I guess what you were doing, it wasn't right. If it was right, you'd be sitting right up here and be on TV with us. So you must be ashamed of what you've done. Well, come on up here. So as I said,
when you say we serve up there, you talk for yourself. You do one quarter of the work on your lives that any of these women have done on their lives, and your lives are going to be better. And you're not going to be contributing to the shit out there in that world that little girls have to deal with and little boys have to deal with.
Religious people say that I deserve what I got. I would say they're absolutely wrong because I wouldn't have been in that situation if someone hadn't taken my innocence away as a very young child. Women would not be on that corner if men weren't looking to buy sex.
I would like people to look at people who are in prostitution as human beings, whether they're in a strip club, whether they're on the street, whether they're in a massage brothel. This is a human being here. And think about what it's really doing to them.
that literally I live doing cards with people who have said that, you know, I'm not my own.
What if another human should know what you're asking yourself?
Yeah! And your little boy's name, Richard?
Mm-hmm.
they were riding bikes together. What did you tell them? When you said he feels somewhat responsible, did you tell what most moms tell kids, stay together?
Stay together. I always tell my children to stay together, you know. And he left Amber because they were in a place that they knew they were supposed to be there. And they know he's supposed to be there with an adult. They weren't too far away from home. So he came home by himself.
Did he kind of go back to the car? Did he see a bicycle there?
I'm telling him he should immediately go get Sissy and come back home. When he goes to look for her, he comes back in maybe a minute. I can't find Sissy. Then that's me.
Did you see a bike?
No, he couldn't see it, find her in anything. So me and my father were outside the whole time. They were only supposed to go around the block like they always have. I grew up in that neighborhood. The neighborhood's supposed to be safe. You know, it was safe for me, it was supposed to be safe for my kids. And my father went to go look for her. He comes back. He says that someone took Amber. I didn't believe him because her bicycle was in the back of his truck, and I just assumed she was in the cab of the truck. And so he was just trying to joke on me. But he said, yes, it's true. The police are already there. The witness, eyewitnesses, and her being abducted was there. I told my father that she was abducted. And from there, my life's in pure hell.
There's hell right now.
It's still hell, yes.
Well, you asked the solid prayer. You asked the man to bring her back. I forgot it. Since it was a witness that said it was a man, he made a lot of appeals to that man, didn't he?
Yes, I prayed and I pleaded on TV. I begged him just to let her go. I'll find her. She'll find her way home. She's smart. She's a smart little girl. She was finding her way home. Just let her go. Please, and I begged and begged, but he didn't.
I don't know where the man is. I can't imagine anyone doing something like that. You must have been hurt terribly in your own life to inflict such misery, pain, and suffering on so many people. But I just, I want to tell you something. If you could just get your life right, if you spent your life in prison, you'd be freer than you are now because you're a tormented person. You're a tormented man. Oh, if you could experience the freedom, whatever that is that caused you to do something like this, whatever you do, please don't ever do it again. What were you going to say, huh?
Just not knowing what he did to her. How long did she have to suffer before he killed her? I know she was molested as well as murdered. Her throat was sliced 5 times. And he did a lot of horrible things to my little girl. And my little girl's slain. She's an innocent little child. And I pray that one day he will be caught. And brought to justice. But I believe in my heart, if we the people here not capture him and bring him to justice, God will.
Yes.
Look at his turn.
Amber must not be forgotten by any of us. And she won't be.
That's
she won't be. We let us look at the picture because of my staff and my producers, who do such an outstanding job of helping us remember in the right way. You were looking at the pictures and you just wanted to look at them. You look at them a lot, and I want to thank you for wearing her picture and helping us remember. She does what when she's close to your heart? What?
Get out of here! once again, it's an honor to somehow share with us some advice.
I'd really like to be around because it's extremely great. She could be at 8th grade level and 3rd grade, and she was so much fun. She just could go back and find the moments when a happy little girl starts to swerve away. And then you could unlock the secret of a life about to go wrong. She was presented with Sheila's father when she was bored, walked out. She was 10 years old. And that disturbed her.
Did you look at those picture questions and things that she became very hard between 13 and 14. So someone between 7th and 8th grade was a graphic thing. And she was really into bringing her.
Thank you. is like a little sunshine in my life, and she brought me so much happiness and so much love and so much everything. Until Bundy took that away from me.
And dealing with having their children die, but not knowing, I could never let my guard down to think about Sarah, to remember her laugh, to watch the videos.
Morning, Sarah.
What?
Morning.
Morning.
Now I want to watch the videos, I want to remember. And look forward to seeing her in heaven.
I screamed. I just started screaming so loud. My mom was sitting on the couch, and she said, "Honey, it's Christy." And it was like, it was a funny reaction. I said, "What?" Yeah, no, I'm sure you're wrong. No.
Use words like murder, killed, homicide, kind of loosely. These kids were butchered. I really prefer to say it that way. Okay? They were cut up not once, many times, by somebody who at that moment did not care for life, did not care for them, wanted to terrorize them. Some were tortured and some were raped. That's important to say it that way. Somebody had absolutely no regard for life, their life, and what it was going to do to the family members when they were doing this.
Why? Why? I don't understand.